Hey guys, welcome back. Today I will be doing a tutorial for someone that really told me how to, basically, how do I do my thumbnails, and they thought I could show that, but it's gonna be a little confusing when I explain the best I can. So you're gonna wanna get this, well, Gimp 2.8, and I'm gonna put this download link in the description below. And you're gonna need your browser for images you really want to put on your thumbnail, which we're gonna create right now. So for YouTube, if you want your image to look good, and good by good I mean HD, is you want it to be 1000 by, I think it was 1080 by 720p. So this is what I always do with my images, and that's the quality they, well, that's what I started doing on my last two videos. My Sanctum, the one I recorded today, and hopefully this video will come out today too. My Sanctum and my Minecraft Hunger Games, so 720p and 1080p, I think, yeah. Okay, and now what you want to do is click OK, and you'll get this box. You can zoom in, zoom out, but I'm just gonna keep it like this. It works like that. And what I usually do for my backgrounds is I just do something like, I click over here, this tool. It's a blend tool. It creates like background areas for like, well, you'll see. I do radial. I pick my color. My color is usually not black and white because that's how it looks like, which is pretty retarded. But then my color is, like, you can make it like this, which is kind of better. Well, it is better. So you can make it, I'm just gonna go with the light color, and now I screwed it up. So you want to go back and now to the part where it's not really screwed up. Well, yeah, I think I screwed mine up. Oh yeah, it's over here, change it. So you want it to be over here, FG to BG, and now, yeah, that's what it should look like. And you can switch that and it looks better. Now you should make this white, so now, yeah, it looks better like this. Or you can switch this around and make it like this, which is usually what I do. So this is my background, and that's what I used for Hunger Games. Pretty much that's how I did it, but it was hard because I added a bunch of shadows. And that's what I'm gonna try to show you guys how to do in this video. Try to explain my best. So you wanna go and search up for an image. So you wanna type in something random for your video, something that relates in your video, and put that in your image. But since I already have something, I'm gonna go open it. I'm gonna go see if I can find my diamond that I saved. I forgot where it was though. Exit. You know what? We'll do this. You might wonder how I did this image and how I made it with my own skin in there, but it's pretty easy. You can go and type in Nova skin, and it's gonna be right over here. And it takes a while to kind of position your character and do it that way. It's pretty hard, but it takes time. It's not something that you, it's not like something that you're gonna do the thumbnail in 10 minutes or so. It takes quite a while if you want it to be a good thumbnail. So you have this, which is in your image. You can resize it using this tool. It's the scale tool. That's a bit fat, so you want to redo that and make it like, put these things together. Now when you do it, it does like both of them at the same time. Now you can take it out of the boundary, which is, it's gonna look like this. It's gonna look like this in your YouTube video, and it's not gonna show the rest, obviously. So you want, I'm just gonna put that back where I want it. So just like this. And now I want to, let's just say, open another, and let go my, go just go to my Minecraft image. You can easily find this Minecraft image also because other people made it in their videos, and YouTube kinda has the history behind that. So there we go. And yeah, that's how you pretty much import your pictures and whatever you wanna call them, or yeah. Now I'm gonna go tell you guys of how to add shadows to your images. My voice just cracked again. So you wanna go to, where was it? Light and shadows, drop shadows, and now it's gonna bring up this thing on your screen over there, or it's gonna just automatically bring it up over there. It doesn't really matter, but you gotta just look carefully. Don't just keep pressing the same thing and open thousands of them. And this is where it's gonna give you offset X, offset Y, and I think Y is on the sides, and X is on the bottom and top. So you want to put that to 5. 5 is pretty regular, and radius, how basically you know what radius is, and capacity of how like dark the color is, and what shadow do you want it to be. For this video demonstration, I'm just gonna go with black regular. And now it looks better. And if, as you guys can see, that's the shadow over there. So if you can't really put that back, you go, oh god, you go back again, and that's where it really usually is. So if you want to make it darker, you can always go light, drop shadow, and let's do radius more. Now it looks better. So you want the character to have shadow too, you do the same thing. You just go light, shadow, drop shadow. Let's go a bit of a darker. Yeah. It looks more catchy and that kind. If you want to add text to your image, you just press the wherever you want it and then just drag it like this. And now you type in, what's it going to be? Tutorial. No. Example. Let's just do example. Example. And you can't really see this, but you can select the part where you typed in just now. Make it bigger. Change your font. Mine is the Adventure. You can easily find this font. It's not hard whatsoever. And yeah, that's how you kinda, well, I usually do this with my images. Make it yellow. No, wait, it's supposed to be a little bit. Make it like, no. Yeah, I usually do this, then I scale it back to its original size. I mean, not the original size, but the one it is right now. Then I move it to where I want it to be. And then what I do is I add shadows to it, so you want to select that image, because if you select a different part of the image or you don't select anything, or it's going to basically go to your background, and if you do that, it's going to drop shadow. It's going to do pretty much this to your image, which is kind of weird. I never screwed around with this, but it adds a bunch of shadows to your image, and if you want, that could be useful, but not for me at the moment. So you want to go to your example, which is this, and then light shadow, drop shadow, do this to your image, and now it looks more, basically it pops out and it's good, as you guys probably tell. It looks good. So that's how you pretty much add shadows, and if you want to screw around with the overlays, you can, but highly suggest the background on the bottom. And how this stuff works is the shadows, I mean, like, the each image you place, it becomes a new layer. When you import the image, it makes itself a new layer, and then it stacks upon each other. So if you wanted this to, like, as you guys can probably tell, the example was imported first, so it stacked onto the image. So if you want that to change, you can always go back to your, select this, go up. If you want to go back, yeah, we should have probably went back. And now this one stacks up to this one. And yeah. So I think that's pretty much it. And if you want to add lighting to your text, that you can do, which is, I think, no, I forgot what it was. Yeah, this adds some lighting to your text, but it looks really, really, really weird. And it kind of screws up your text sometimes. Well, for me it does. I don't even know if it's only me that glitches out over there. But it can be useful. But I'm just gonna leave it like this. So if you guys enjoyed this little video, hope you leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends who are starting on YouTube and want to make custom thumbnails. And if you want to have the option to custom thumbnails, I think you're gonna have to like get 10 subs or something. I'm not exactly sure, so don't like bombard me of comments saying no, you don't need to do that and whatever. Like, I got the custom thumbnails option like a few years now, and I've been using it for a few years now, so I don't even know. It probably changed by now. So hope you guys enjoyed this little video. If you did, like I said, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends, family, and business owners, whoever want to make thumbnails. This is just Minecraft example, I guess, but you can always change this to like business or whatever other game you want it to be. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next video, and take care.